Namaste viewers, welcome to Jnana Degula channel. In this video we will see some of the aspects, some of the information on Chandra. It's a lunar deity. It's called as Chandra is one among the Navagrahas. Namasuryaya Chandraya Mangalaya Buddhaya cha Guru Shukra Shanibhyascha Rahave Ketuve Namaha. So here Namasuryaya Mangalaya, after Surya, the second is that Namasuryaya Somaya or Chandraya. Namasuryaya Chandraya. So now this Chandra is also known as Soma. He holds different roles as both a deity and a personification of a sacred drink, Soma, Soma Rasa, they call it. If we trace back to the Vedic texts, Chandra emerges as a significant deity, revered as the lord of, he is controller of the plants, forests, rivers and earth, and hailed as the father of the gods. So Chandra means all these earthly related things, you know. This is he controls, or he is the lord of all these atmosphere, we can say. Now in the ninth mandala of Rigveda, it is dedicated entirely to Soma, showcasing the deity's paramount importance in ancient Vedic civilization. Soma, in the Vedic era, when it transitioned into post-Vedic times, after the Vedic times, Chandra assumed the guise of a lunar deity, often associated with epithets like Chandra. According to various texts like the Ramayana, Mahabharata, Purana, Chandra is depicted as the son of the sage Atri and his wife Anasuya. Atri and Anasuya, they were the parents of Chandra. In some of the literature accounts, he is an avatar of creator god Brahma also. The legends surrounding Chandra's birth vary with different texts attributing his parentage to figures like Dharma, Prabhakara, all these kinds of things, you know, it is attributed to. One captivating story from the Puranas narrates the love story between Chandra and Tara. Chandra Tara Sutam. Chandra Tara. So the wife of Brihaspati, the guru of the Devas. Despite being married, Chandra and Tara fell in love, leading to a conflict between Chandra and Brihaspati. After a war was averted through divine intervention, Tara gave birth to the son named Buddha, whose paternity became a subject of dispute between Chandra and Brihaspati. The story goes like this. Ultimately, Brahma, you know, the creator of the universe, he intervened. He confirmed Chandra as Buddha's father, thus establishing the Chandra Vamsha dynasty. So this is a very tricky story where Chandra falls in love with Tara. Already Tara is wife of Brihaspati. The guru of the Brihaspati is the teacher of the Devas. All these kinds of stories are there. Anyway, another legend involves an encounter between Chandra and Ganesha. It is very famously known in the Puranas, in the story of Ganesha, where a playful jest by Chandra, that means Chandra, very playful, in he makes a comment on Ganesha. Ganesha curses him, resulting in the moon's waxing and waning phases. This is what the story was. This story also explains the presence of a prominent crater on the moon, visible even from Earth. So, this is a small different story. Chandra's matrimonial alliances are equally very fascinating. He is said to have married 27 daughters of Prajapati, Daksha, each representing a constellation near the moon. That is 27 nakshatras, Ashwini, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, Mrugashara. Like this it goes on, 27. Each representing a constellation near the moon. However, Chandra's favoritism towards Rohini, one of his wives, it led to jealousy among the others and invoked a curse from Daksha. This is what some kind of a story going on. In contemporary Hindu traditions, Chandra remains a revered deity, symbolizing the enigmatic beauty and mystique of the moon. His stories continue to captivate devotees and enthusiasts alike, offering insights into ancient beliefs and cosmic phenomena. Now, there is a mention in Vedas that Chandrama Manaso Jataha Chakshuhu Suryo Ajayata. It goes on like this. Chandra is responsible for your mental stability also. Manas. So he has an effect on the manas also. It is quoted in the Vedas. Chandrama Manaso Jataha Chakshuhu Suryo Ajayata. Like this it goes on. As the deity, this Chandra deity, lunar deity, waxes and wanes, Shukla Paksha and the other one, Krishna Paksha, it is called as Shukla Paksha and Krishna Paksha. One is the increasing in the brightness, the other is decrease in the brightness of the moon. 16 in 16 degrees, it comes down. Shodashakala, they call it Shodashakaladaram, Indum, Shodashakaladaram, Indira Sahodaram. All these things, they all have lot of stories. Hindu means Chandra has got 16, Shodasha means 16 kalas, different brightness measures. Indira Sahodaram, Indira means Lakshmi, Sahodaram means brother, because he was born in the story of Samudra Manthan, Kshira Sagara Manthan, Chandra was born, Lakshmi was born, Indira Sahodaram, like this it goes on. So this is the these are some of the facts of Chandra which have been mentioned in the our ancient literature. Viewers, with this we will conclude this video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel. We will continue with some more videos on moon and other things. Thank you for viewing.